In the 1960s, way before anybody had ever tweeted, Facebook lived, or sent classified information to WikiLeaks, one man made a series of pronouncements about the changing media landscape. His name was Marshall McLuhan, and you've probably heard his most quoted line, "The medium is the message." McLuhan's theories on the media were groundbreaking in the 60s, and if you read them today, they would seem prophetic. McLuhan was writing about the effects of the mass media on our lives, but he wasn't talking about the content, the information itself. He was talking about the form, the technologies that provide you with content. McLuhan wasn't saying that content is inconsequential. He was saying that when we pay too much attention to it, we ignore the power of form in shaping our experience. So, if you don't understand the medium, you don't fully understand the message. Think about it. Once upon a time, books were handwritten, but someone invented the printing press and mass media became a reality. The form changed our collective experience. It informed identity, how we imagined ourselves. Same with electronic media, telegraphs, telephones, television, devices that redefined time and space and extended our experience beyond our boundaries. Then came the World Wide Web, the internet. It has changed how we live in the world.
That a medium is not something neutral. It does something to people. It takes hold of them, it roughs them up, it massages them, it bumps them around.
Another strange effect of this electric environment is the total absence of secrecy. With the end of secrecy goes the end of monopolies of knowledge.
Everything happens at once. There's no continuity, there's no connection, there's no follow-through. It's just all now.